The multiband dynamics effect gives you access to three separate processing bands, each with their own dynamics processor. It can select from upwards and downwards expansion, as well as upwards and downwards compression. Let's have a look at the effect in action using these different modes. In our first example, we have a music piece, and I'd like to bring out the high frequencies of the guitar stems. By using the upward expansion mode with a high threshold on the higher frequencies, we can use the ratio value to dial in how much additional brightness we're adding. Next up, we have a forest wildlife ambience, and I'd like to be able to control how much of the high frequencies are present. By using the downward expansion mode, we can create a type of frequency-based noise removal, reducing the amount of high frequencies based on how intense they are. This gives us a smoother and more transparent result than regular EQ would. While this event is playing, let's have a look at the ambience mix bus and look at the compression modes while we're there. If we wanted to go in the other direction and bring out some of the quieter aspects of this ambience, then we could use the upward compression mode. By adjusting the frequency band, threshold, and ratio, we can bring out more of the quieter elements without overpowering the signal. Lastly, let's check out the downwards compression mode using a music track. By using all three bands, we're dynamically controlling how intense any one band can get by compressing the signal if it gets over the threshold. We're then using the post-gain controls to boost the compressed signal to even out the final result.